my world, share my life, trust in me. Hi everybody, welcome back to Cooking with the Special V. It's been a minute, but I'm back, guys. Today I'm gonna show you how I cook my collard greens with oxtails. If you guys like collard greens and oxtails, it's the best combination. It'd be so good. So I have my oxtails here, I have my greens, I have my two onions, and I have my butter, and of course I have all my seasonings here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do first, y'all, I want to say that I don't own the rights to the music that you hear in the background, and I do still have with me Mr. Special V behind the camera, and of course he always has his beer. Okay, so what I'm going to do first, y'all, is I'm going to wash my oxtails off, and then I'm going to put them in my big pot here. I got over here, it already has water in it, they're ready. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to boil them down good enough until the water gets low. And then what I do next is I use beef broth. Okay? This is important. The beef broth is what's going to give it that different type of flavor. Okay? Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rinse these off, y'all. And then I'm going to I'm gonna put all these oxtails into the pot, and I'll be back. Everybody, I have the oxtails in the pot, and the water. So, and I also have my seasoning in there. I didn't put a whole lot. This is just, you know, for the oxtails when they boil down. This is about how much water you want to put in there. You know, let them boil down till it's real, real low. Keep an eye on it. Once it get real low, then we are at the beef broth in, okay? So I will be back with you guys once these boil down. Hey guys, okay. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show y'all how I cut my greens. I will show the easy way on how to cut them. Back in the day when my mama used to make greens, she showed me to peel the stem off. She told me to do it the old fashioned way, like taking a leaf off like that, which that's a more consuming step. This one is easier and faster, and I like the way that it's cut when you put it in the pot, so you have more room. All right, so you always want to make sure you have a big knife. You know, and I was real like skeptical about this cut, the way I would show how to cut this, because I don't like stems. But it's going to be some stems in there, but not a whole lot. It's going to be a little bit of stems, but the stems is good. You can't even really tell. So what I do first is basically I will cut how far of a stem I want to cut them off at. So I'm going to start up here. And you just take these and, you know, toss them, throw them away. You want to make sure you get a good knife, a good sharp knife. They'll cut faster. And what you do is you just grab them, hold it like this, and do them as thin as you want, or as thick as you want. As you can see, that's about, you know, the stems in there, but if you don't like how the size of these, the way I cut it, you can cut it even thinner. You can make them thinner. And you just keep cutting them like this. And as you can see, how they cut so perfect. So I'm gonna show y'all again. And then I'm gonna finish cutting all my greens. I'm gonna clean them. And then when I come back, I'm gonna show y'all what the oxtails look like, because they're gonna be steamed all the way down. And then I'll be ready to put my beef broth in. Okay, so guys, I'll see y'all in a little bit. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm gonna show you guys that the oxtails has cooked all the way down. That's about how far you should let them cook down. You guys see that? Okay, I'm gonna that's when you go ahead and pour the beef broth in.
They look good too.
Yeah, they do look good. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and pour the beef broth in here.
How many do you use?
I'm gonna use one because you don't want, it's gonna still boil down because you don't want your greens to have a bunch of water. You don't want to make soup greens, so you don't want your greens floating. So go ahead and leave it like that, and then I'm gonna add my greens in, and I'll be back. Okay y'all, I got my greens in the pot. Got my onions on top. I got onions in the middle as well. I'm being silly, but yeah, I cut my onions in chunks. As you can see, you don't have to, like I was saying, you don't have to cut them in chunks if you don't want to. You can cut them how you want. I also put some butter in here, put like a stick of butter, y'all. All right, and then you just let them cook. They're gonna steam down. It might take about 2 hours for the greens to cook totally, or however long you want to cook them. Okay, I'm gonna put the lid on. I'm gonna turn. Ooh, that's hot. Why that lid hot?
Because it was sitting on the stove.
Why is that stove on?
Remember the what's the name?
Oh shit. Sorry y'all, I'm burning my hand. And just turn the, turn your eye down, medium. And then just let them cook for a couple of hours. And I will be back when they are done. Hey everybody, welcome back. I got the greens. They're done. Ooh, as you can see, look at that. With the oxtail falling off. Smells so good. Okay, I'm going to a little bit, because my son, he wants to taste them. He said he wants to be the taste tester today. I'm going to give him a little oxtail like that. I'm still going to let these cook a little bit longer, but I'm going to put it on low. Tell me the truth, son. My collard greens and oxtail.
Whoa.
See how that meat falling off that bone? Ooh. He don't know what to do, y'all. Blow it, that shit hot.
All right. What we working with.
Oh, that stuff hot.
Fresh out the box.
So flavorful, y'all. I taste them. Ooh, they so flavorful.
He gonna put that little piece back on and blow it back off.
Okay. Ooh. That look good. You it did look good. Good.
Right,
it
did look so good.
It's really good.
Look at this dude.
Look, first place.
Zeus, you ain't getting none. Aflac.
Well, okay, guys, that's it. Them are my collard greens and oxtails. So good. I'm glad you guys came to watch my video today. The ones who's just tuning into my channel, give me a thumbs up. Let me know what you think about today's video. Make sure you put your comments in the comment. Go ahead and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.